And by the way, I mean, there have been draft commercials everywhere. They bought time on Impact. They bought time on Dynamite. People watching Dynamite saw commercials for the WWE draft. So they're trying. But the issue is, it's not that people don't know it's the draft show. The issue is that people don't care. Because every year it's the same thing. Well, we have guys from SmackDown on Raw now. The champion is a guy from the other brand, right? And then we've got, you know, the Survivor Series is coming up. So we're going to see everybody from both shows anyway. I mean, what is the draw? We saw this last year. What is the draw of the draft now? You don't stick to it before. You don't stick to it after. You always come up with some wacky rule to send people wherever you want to send them. What's the draw? The robot? I don't know.
Isn't it crazy that one of the draws is, hey, you know that team that you like or that group that you like? We might break them up. Like, that's one of the selling points of the show, which is kind of funny. But the what are they going to do? I mean, even if you include NXT and you bring up Io Shirai and you bring up Dakota Kai, and that's cool. I like that. If you send somebody down to NXT, I don't know who that would be, but whatever. Great. But when it comes to the big names, like, what's the gimmick? We've seen the gimmick a million times. They're probably going to trade Damian Priest and Nakamura, which makes sense for both of them. They've been there both sides long enough, switched the titles back over, but we've seen it a million times. Who are the big names you can drag in that are going to be big for Fox and USA? Okay, they might use Goldberg. They might use Brock Lesnar. They may... But, okay, what does that mean really at the end of the day? It doesn't really mean anything. You know, it doesn't. It might mean something to them, but, like, you're only going to see Brock Lesnar so many times on either show. You're only going to see Goldberg so many times. It's like they're nice pawns to use for big names going back and forth in the draft, but when you never see them, who cares? How many times have you seen Naomi on TV since the last draft? Naomi was the, like, number three pick of SmackDown or something like that. Then she was gone. It's like
Let me jump in here.
You can have it, but I don't know what kind of fresh spin that you can put on this that would make it make any sense to even bother.
I got a fresh thing I want to spin right here. Why do we even have a brand split?
Not a clue.
Okay, listen. I heard every stupid excuse in the old days. My favorite being, well, we have to run two tours. I mean, even if you, like, could not figure out how to run two tours unless you split the brands, I mean, you're not running two tours anymore. You know what's funny is in order to sell tickets to their house shows, they only run super shows with people from both brands. So it's like they know to sell tickets, they need to combine the brands, yet they won't combine the brands on television. Then people are like, oh, well, you know, we'd see the same guys on both shows. Well, yeah, if you suck at booking, I mean, you realize you don't have to have a brand split to have different people wrestling on different shows. And then if you need somebody from the other side, you just move them over there. I mean, I don't know if you guys are aware of this or not, but AEW has two shows. How many times have you seen the same people wrestling on Wednesday as on Friday? Oh, they have different people wrestling on the Wednesday show than the Friday show without a brand split? How could they possibly do that? Well, you know, it's not hard. You just have different people wrestle on Friday than we're wrestling on Wednesday. So I don't know. There's literally at this point, there's no, here's the thing. Let's say that every year when you did the draft, you did like a gigantic number. Okay. Then you could at least argue that, well, it's useless for 364 days, but on the draft day, we do a big number for the draft. If that was like your only reason, it'd be like, all right, well, that's one thing. Well, we saw last year, and the indications are this year, that nobody cares about the draft. So nobody cares about the draft. Your house shows sell tickets based on the entire roster. You're not running two house show tours. What? Name one reason that we need to have two brands. Anybody?
Do you want a WWE reason?
Bro, I don't care what reason it is. You can give me a reason from someone that lives on Mars. Give me one reason why we need to have two different brands.
because to NBC Universal and to Fox, you are selling them what makes your product unique than the other one. What did we bid on? What makes us special? Who are you going to give us? What's the big star?
Yeah, but all I hear is that they're upset that Brock Lesnar showed up and he's going to be on the SmackDown brand and not Raw. It'd be pretty damn easy to just go, oh, well, don't worry. He's going to be on both shows. Fox wants Brock. Ryan, great. USA
you're
wants
exactly
Brock.
Right. Oh,
he's going to be there as well.
You're
then
exactly
your
right.
television partners aren't upset either. So I'm waiting for one good reason why we need to have a brand split.
Because,
one.
Well, but hold on. But by your definition, what you just said there runs opposite of what I said, which would be what I would assume would be a selling point is what makes it unique. If they're on both shows, if Roman is on both shows, which he should be, but if he's since he's not, that's what makes SmackDown unique. That's what a selling point for Fox would be. Again, I'm not saying it's a good reason, but I'm saying it's a reason that business-wise, much like YouTube numbers that at the end of the day don't mean diddly squat, you know, that's what they use them for as a selling point. And apparently it works because Fox gave him a bunch of money, I guess. I just... Again, there is no good reason. And it started with, like, noble roots. If you wanted to, like, have the brand split, have stars on both sides, but we've seen over time, and it happened very quickly, that it wasn't the right thing to do. It's a bad gimmick that has, much like Money in the Bank, it has long ago become a useless tool that... It doesn't seem to pop ratings. It doesn't seem to be a big fall spectacular for these networks. So I wish it would just go away. It's stupid. Just build towards Survivor Series during this time. Make your shows hot for the fall season premiere and just be done with it that way. It's a silly thing.
This person says WWE has too many people to put on just one show. They need to split the roster to feature everyone. What do you mean one show? They have two shows. And unless you literally have... a stegosaurus brain, you can figure out how to feature everyone by putting half of them on one show and half on the other, but not making it an official split so that then you get stuck. Oh, someone went down with an injury. Well, now
this
what?
Isn't new. This stuff is not new. Like, the Jim Crockett Promotions would run three towns a night. They would tape TV on, like, Wednesday, two shows back to back. And they would have different people on both shows because they had a big roster and they had multiple storylines that people were into. Like, all that stuff, if you concentrated on that as opposed to some of this other nonsense, you'd probably be a lot better off. But who am I? A wrestling fan.
Back in a moment, Observer Live. If you enjoy these videos, for just $7.99 per month, you can enjoy full-length editions of The Bryan and Vinny Show, Wrestling Observer Live, Figure Four Daily with Tom Lawler and Lance Storm, plus hundreds of archived shows, all in beautiful HD. Don't miss out. Join us today.